So they caught just now, so I didn't take the jugular. Anyway, it's taken from jugular vein. So now the blood collected because the dog has fever. And also in preparation for the operation, the electrical canal section. Let me just video this again there. So the blood was collected from the jugular vein. You can press down here and then you can see, experienced nurse can see, but I can see, I can press and see. She can show, when she press down, the assistant holds her head up, like in the horse, in the race horse. Just now I didn't switch on the recording button, so so here they can feel, as the jugular vein there.
Yeah.
You press below and then the needle goes in. Okay, finish. Then the collected, then they send for lab tests, including the swab. Where's the swab? So this is the swab the ear for the bacteria culture and antibiotic sensitivity. Okay, then these are the two. So after that, we're gonna do the ear irrigation, we sedate, and then we do the blood test. No, I mean we do the sedation IV.
Okay.
Zolotil 0.4, Zolotil 100, and then after that, our irrigation, we will treat antibiotics for about 2 weeks, and then operation will be to open up the ear canal. It's called lateral ear canal resection, which you open up the side wall.
Yeah.
Cut away. I think you have seen it, right? You have seen it done?
I haven't seen it being done before.
Okay. And there will be drainage and ventilation, even though the ear might be floppy, because once you open up the side wall, you show the horizontal canal here.
Yeah.
Then it just drains out. There's no more trapping of the shampoo, the liquid. Now the other possibility, of course, is allergy to something. But in these floppy ear dogs, the first diagnosis is still due to anatomy. That's why the chronic otitis external comes in. And then the owner has been using commercial ear drops, but apparently it doesn't work. And this shows that probably last few weeks. Then you can see the site also there. The site. The only interesting thing is sometimes due to this lower resistance, the mites come in. The Demodex might come in as well. And the side don't have, right? Turn over the belly. Turn the other side.
Honey.
1, 2, 3. Okay, go that side. You turn over.
Okay.
1, 2, 3. See that below. You can see even worse here. There. It's very much bad here. Very bad here. So,
Jess, honey,
possible
it's
allergy,
okay, honey,
but it's a bacterial infection. Quite deep. And then here. Here, so yeah, the ventral. And the dermatitis, in fact, this is bad, yeah.
Oh, honey.
Okay, so this could be dermatitic mites and bacteria and fungal infections as well. Whether the primary cause is the ear or they are separate matters, it's hard to say. Okay. Okay, so take